Brazilian Army has, through its history, been contributing to the formation of the Brazilian nationality by preparing men and women morally and intellectually fired with a sense of boldness and patriotism. Through its educational establishments, it prepares highly qualified, trained and motivated human resources, which are the most important part of the institution. With the coming of the Portuguese royal family to Brazil in 1808, the Royal Military Academy was created through an act by the Prince Dom João. The Academy started working on April 23, 1811, in Casa do Trem, now the National History Museum in Rio de Janeiro. During our empire and in the beginning of the Republican era, having been established in Largo de São Francisco, in Praia Vermelha, in Porto Alegre, and in Realengo, the military teaching had successive changes. In order to comply with the demands of modernity, the Military School of Resende, nowadays Academia Militar das Agulhas Negras, AMAN, was created in 1944. The ideal power of Marshal José Pessoa Cavalcante de Albuquerque, idealizer of AMAN, finally had come true. The Military Academy is a college-level institution which has the mission to prepare line combat officers for the Brazilian Army, whose preparation starts at the Escola Preparatória de Cadetes in the city of Campinas, São Paulo, after a selection through official examination. The educational activities at the Military Academy aim at the development of the affective, cognitive and psychomotor domains, and they are guided by curricula and methods avowed by the National Educational Rules. Upon graduation, the graduate is declared officer to be and is granted a bachelor degree in military sciences. The Brazilian Military Academy, placed at the foot of Agulhas Negras Peak, lays along the Presidente Dutra Highway between Rio de Janeiro and São Paulo. The academy is spread over an area of about 6-7 square kilometers, featuring 703,000 square meters of beauty areas. There are two big sectors in the Military Academy in charge of implementing the complex structure directed to the teaching-learning process operationalization. The Academic Board is responsible for planning and coordinating the school management and for the assessment of the learning process. To do so, besides a planning and evaluation section and a center for personal development, there are a teaching section which coordinates several specialties, libraries, which make the research work easier, an audiovisual aids section and the modern publishing section. The Corps of Cadets is responsible for the night and day accompaniment of the cadets for carrying out the specific military science, for the maintenance of the military discipline, and for the execution of the field maneuvers and drills. In the freshman year, the cadet joins the basic course, the teaching of which is directed to the individual tactics and which has a main objective to forge the basic individual combatants. It also aims to stimulate dedication, persistence, and leadership, domains considered essential for the efficiency of men in modern combat. On the reception of the saber ceremony, the first-year cadet receives the saber, a miniature of the underfitted sword of Duke of Caxias under the national colors and wearing the historical uniform, which represents the symbol of military honor. The sophomore year or advanced course is directed to the formation of small troops leaders and to the continuity of the military sciences teaching. Upon completion of sophomore year, the cadet chooses a branch according to his intellectual merit within the graduation class. The second phase corresponds to the junior and senior years and it supplements the academic formation, enabling the cadet to fulfill the tasks of lieutenant and junior captain from the armies and services according to the branch chosen. During this period, the knowledge concerning tactical module will be dependent by the integration of several courses, taking into account that the lieutenant and the captain will complete their formation through the practical exercise in the military organizations. In junior year, the cadet joins one of the seven available branches in order to continue the military science learning. In the infantry course, the unbeatable warrior will be formed, who will learn how to accomplish missions of any nature in any type of terrain. In the cavalry course, the cadet will develop initiative and boldness, will study the acting in the avant-garde of regular combat and in reconnaissance and security missions. In the artillery course, which gives firing support essential to the battle success, the cadet will learn the deployment of missiles, rockets, cannons, howitzers, and their trajectories. In the engineering course, the cadet will act in troop mobility and counter-mobility, in the construction and maintenance of the roads, bridges, fortifications, obstacles, and destructions. In the quartermaster's course, the cadet will plan the delivery of supplies in the battlefield or in peacetime, essential role of the logistics and financial administration in support to the ground force. In the Sinocorps, the cadet will learn the command, control, and electronic warfare techniques necessary to establish communication of the brigades and the divisions. In the ordnance course, the cadet will learn how to predict, provide, and maintain material, especially vehicles and the weapon systems of the ground force. The fourth and senior year converge predominantly on military activities so as to end the formation of the combat officer. The syllabus includes inter-arm field exercises called tactical modules, which has as main objective to allow the cadet the practice of command functions in a field training exercise. Parallel to the course instruction, regular activities are developed, which are considered fundamental to the improvement of the military character. Among those, there are: the military physical training provides the physical fitness needed to enhance the cadet's performance in the field exercises. The intramural Olympic Games enhance the sense of brotherhood in the most authentic Olympic spirit. The rifle and pistol marksmanship instructions are carried out in the modern facilities of the firing range, aiming at the training in one of the most important military activities. The several special instructions permit the cadet to face challenges in several missions, in continuing operations, under controlled psychological pressure and maximum combat simulation. The horse riding practice has the main objective to stimulate initiative, decision-making, and courage, indispensable characteristics in combat. The academic maneuver is a field exercise in which all branches accomplish missions in an integrated manner, providing the cadet the best conditions to carry out his command tasks. The duty services let the cadet carry out commanding duties and so understand deeply the tasks of their subordinates. The characteristics pursued in the Brazilian Army forge the behavior and the attitudes of the cadet of the Military Academy of Agulhas Negras, helping him develop the military virtues. When Marshal José Pessoa Cavalcante de Albuquerque idealized the creation of the Military Academy, he did not believe he would make history. The power of his idea remains marked on the solid and imposing structure of this academy and seals the responsibility of his sons in keeping it as the school in charge of preparing the leaders par excellence of the Brazilian Army.